Good afternoon and welcome to today's Daily Market Update. My name is James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK. We're going to look at the major stories moving financial markets so far today. And of course, the major stories so far today have been out of China and out of Australia. Some pretty weak numbers coming out overnight, which has really started this week off on a fairly negative note. We've seen equity markets fall into the downside. We've seen various different currency pairs start off with a little bit more of a negative real feeling. But there's a lot of data coming out this week, and it's going to be a busy week. So really, it's looking at maybe a bit of reaction to what happened last week as well, because of course we've seen such big falls in equity markets in some of the currencies last week, all on the back of these worries about the emerging markets. Of course, we had the Fed last week as well. So all of those stories have really culminated, and now overnight last night, weaker numbers out of China and Australia, and that is really starting this week off where we left off last week. Now, in terms of equity markets, we're not too much to the downside. I mean, in Europe, we're around 20 odd points to the downside on the FTSE, the DAX and the CAC also falling down to those sorts of levels. But in currencies, we're a little bit more mixed. We've seen some moves one way or the other. But definitely in terms of the currency markets, it's going to be a matter of waiting for the rest of this data later in the week. Now, what have we got this week which is really going to highlight things? We've got the ECB. That's going to be the one of the biggest stories of the week. And of course, last week we heard the fact that we saw the CPI inflation numbers come out. Now, going back a few months, we have to remember that what the ECB did was cut their interest rates yet again. Now, they cut those rates to try and quell this fear of deflation, this very low inflation rates. And what we saw last week was inflation fall yet again. So the story really is that it's not the rate cut that we saw from the ECB a few months back isn't having the effect that we thought it was going to have. Now, Mario Draghi said a few weeks back that he did expect inflation to stay stubbornly low for a longer period of time, but the feeling will be that the interest rate cut that we saw isn't doing the job that we expected it to. And the big story is that the big discussion point is why aren't the ECB looking for an asset purchasing program, a quantitative easing program, just to try and kickstart that economy? Because when we look at economies around the world, we look at the UK as currently the shining light in terms of economic recovery, strong GDP growth, good inflation figures, unemployment falling the right way. When we look to the US, they're tapering. Last week we saw a second round of tapering, another $10 billion taken from that asset purchasing program last month. So that is showing signs that the economy doesn't need that stimulus. Now, what we're seeing in the Eurozone is that it very much does. Even a rate cut isn't helping that situation. The inflation levels are stubbornly low. That fear of deflation is there. So the rate cut hasn't worked. And it's going to be very interesting to see this week what Mario Draghi says and what happens at the meeting, and just to see whether we're going to get any more movements in monetary policy if the Eurozone and the ECB think that to help this Eurozone economy, we're going to need to act tougher and act quickly to get this economy going again. Because, of course, at the moment, that wide-ranging economy of the Eurozone isn't doing what it was hoped to be doing after that interest rate cut a few months back. So the ECB is going to be very much at the forefront of people's mind this week, looking towards the euro, see how the euro reacts to those things. Euro-dollar, of course, being the one, because after the dollar moves last week and the more tapering, we're going to want to see some kind of reaction from the euro this week. Now, as we move through, it's not just the Eurozone that takes the headlines. Later on in the week, and of course the major story is going to be the non-farm payroll figure, the unemployment figure, the jobs report out of the US. Now, I've already said how the US is now looking pretty good in terms of economic recovery. We've had another round of tapering. We've seen the market like that and start to move higher. Equities haven't necessarily done that because, of course, last week has been at that worry about the emerging markets and the continued a few negative earnings as well. So last week has been that bit more negative. So the one thing that could get us going this week may not happen till Friday, of course, but it would be a strong non-farm payroll number. And actually, over the last few months, these numbers have been drastically different from what the expectations have been. So what we're going to be looking towards is the ADP number on Wednesday. So we have the non-farm payroll and the full jobs report on Friday, but we get an ADP payroll number on Wednesday to give us an indication of where those numbers are going to go on Friday. Then we'll have the initial jobless claims on Thursday. They're the weekly jobs numbers that come out. So both of those could give us a more rounded picture of where we're going to go in terms of the non-farm payroll. But then we'll wait till Friday to see those big numbers, of course. So there's a lot of data coming out this week. But as for today, We're looking towards that China and that Australian data that's really given us a bit of a, started us off on the back foot. But hopefully as we move through the week, the ECB, maybe the US in terms of non-farm payrolls and unemployment numbers later in the week could get us going again. But so far, it's been a bit of a negative start for the week. For more news analysis, go to alpari.co.uk/newsroom. Thank you very much for listening. My name is James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK.